cargo business makes a lot of sense. There's a lot of it, and there's enough of it to justify substantial private investment, which can be recovered against the available contracts. One could, in theory, and even at some level of meaningfulness, in fact, argue that there ought to be a business carrying people. The problem is, for the existing market for human transport to orbit, the entire business is basically 2 to 4 missions a year, depending on how big your spacecraft is. But for a 3 to 4 person spacecraft, there's a maximum of 4 missions a year for complete supply of everybody who has to get to and from the space station. And half of those missions are going to be sovereign to the Russian government. So the commercial case is 2 missions. It's very, very difficult to justify building a human-rated spacecraft in order to fly twice a year, you know, on a private sector basis. I do not see how it works out. Now, that's the near term. There is data indicating extremely large unmet demand for human spaceflight. But that demand is at price points way below current prices, like a factor 10 at least. So today there's no way of accessing that demand. But you know, in the long run, there is clear-cut opportunity for somebody, if they can figure out how to cut costs by a factor of 10, to generate literally many tens of billions of dollars a year in revenue transporting folks into Earth orbit for, to be blunt, vacations. And the problem here is, although there's a good business case, there's a time value of money problem. It costs so much money to develop a commercially funded spacecraft that could fly into orbit at low cost and return, human rated, safe enough to do this job. The kind of investment is in the tens of billions. And trying to get that money back in 6 or 7 years is basically impossible. So you're left with a market failure. You can't get there on a private investment basis. And the government politically cannot justify spending tens of billions of dollars developing a spaceship so that rich people can take vacations in Earth orbit, even though there is enormous demand for that, and it would significantly add to the economy. But it's, we don't justify these kinds of investments based on their return to the economy. So for the moment, things are stuck. How, in the long run, anything's possible. Some of the issues become technological. Chemical rockets are probably not the right technical choice for getting much beyond Earth orbit. It can be shown that if it cost as little as $100 a pound to put things into Earth orbit, and that's near as low as it could get with chemical rockets, that it would still cost $5,000 a pound to send things to the moon. That's just the physics. And $5,000 a pound is about the current cost of getting things into Earth orbit, and at that price, there is very, very little. It's something that there's very little transport. It is something that is largely reserved for governments and extremely large corporations. It's just, you know, in any reasonable time frame, even a lunar colony is not a likely outcome as long as we're dependent on chemical rockets. And that in turn implies the requirement for new technology, and there's some potential technologies, but nothing today that is going to pay off in the next 50 years. It's arguable that people who invest in space transportation as a business lose their shirts. And I can show, not counting the partially government-funded expendable evolved expendable launch vehicle program, I could count at least $2 billion of private investment that's gone into private development of space launch systems over the last, well, since 1980. Of that, you can count about 40 plus revenue launches of the Pegasus launch vehicle, which was privately developed, and a couple of launches of the Athena launch vehicle, which was also privately developed, totaling maximum a few hundred million dollars, $600-700 million of revenue back. So ignoring the time value of money or anything else, that $2 billion would have been better spent if it had been put in a checking account. I mean, just we've spent about $2 billion of private resources getting about $700 million of private return. Doesn't make sense. It's not a good investment, and it's not likely to be a good investment. On the flip side, it's necessary. There are certain things, certain payloads that simply must fly, almost irrelevant of the price. And given that there is national security demand, somebody has to do it. So even though it's a lousy business, I have a friend who does strategic planning for one of the major launch companies, and he says, if we could figure out how to get out of this business, we would. But somebody does have to do it. And so, you know, you see a handful of companies that stay in. But nobody is making a fortune in the aerospace business. It's a low margin, intensely technical business that involves a lot of risk. Literally every single time we launch a rocket, we take a pretty much binary risk on outcome. That's, you can lose them for almost any reason every launch. So it's a high risk, low return. Why would you do that?